After a false alarm, opening day is actually here. Oh, get a roof over there in Queens, New York. It is time for baseball season. The Milwaukee Brewers finally get their opening day after it was rained out yesterday. Now, here on Friday, March 29th, we're going to get you caught up on three big storylines that you need to be aware of heading into this Milwaukee Brewers season. It's been a lot of Badgers, but here we are covering all things Wisconsin sports 6 days a week on the Scotty Six Pack. Good morning, and thank you for enjoying it with the Six Pack. This the Scotty Six Pack, the only daily podcast talking all things Wisconsin sports with you. I'm your host, Kedrick Stumbris. You can find me on the website, formerly known as Twitter, at Kedrick Stumbris, and follow the podcast at Scotty Six Pack for the latest updates in Wisconsin sports. Hey, this has been a huge couple of days for the show. So if you're new here, thank you very much for hanging around. We really appreciate it. If you've been catching us in your feed lately, look, one of the best things that you can do to help improve the show, help us get even better guests, help us massively improve the content for you. One of the best things that you can do is just subscribe. We're looking, and 92% of you are not subscribed to the show. So if you're watching on YouTube, youtube.com/@ScottySixPack, just hit that subscribe button. It's free. Doesn't cost you anything. And helps us make even better content for all of you. We're going to talk some Milwaukee Brewers because the Brewers have their first pitch at 12:40 p.m. Central today at Citi Field in New York against the Mets, against the old GM David Stearns. And this is a very different Brewers team than we had certainly 2 years ago. And even quite a bit different from just a year ago. And it all starts with the man of the hour. Jackson Chourio is here. Yes, Jackson Chourio. I got the Timber Rattlers hat on, Wisconsin single A affiliate up in Grand Chute near my hometown. And I have the Timber Rattlers Chourio jersey situation while we're at it. He's number 3 on the Timber Rattlers, but number 11 with the Milwaukee Brewers, as Jackson Chourio is the most exciting prospect in baseball right now. Look, if you're looking, he's probably number 2 at most places in terms of prospects, while Jackson Holliday of the Baltimore Orioles organization is number 1. But Jackson Chourio is as great of a baseball prospect as you are going to find just about anywhere. The 20-year-old from Venezuela is making his major league debut on opening day, just the 8th Brewer of all time to make his opening day MLB debut. Incredible, incredible feat for him. There's only been 5 players to debut younger than Jackson Chourio. Jackson Chourio enters Major League Baseball as the youngest player on a Major League roster. He is the first player born in 2004 to make his MLB debut. And he's hitting leadoff. He is hitting leadoff. So all this, he's incredibly young, makes his way up through the minor league ranks. He spent about 3 weeks at Double A to end his season before, and he is skyrocketing up through the ranks. Sorry, spent about 3 weeks 2 summers ago in High A with Wisconsin, made his way all the way up through Carolina with the Mudcats very quickly, closed out the season at Wisconsin, and then shot up directly to Double A and spent most of the season there last summer in Double A before finishing his year off in Triple A Nashville, and now comes to the Brewers after just hammering the ball. He is a roving center fielder. I think that will ultimately be where he ends up playing with the Brewers. Right now, center fielder is Blake Perkins on the opening day roster as Jackson Chourio leads off in right field. But he is a generational talent. And if the Milwaukee Brewers are ever going to win a World Series, something that I personally doubt that they'll be able to do in the current structural makeup of Major League Baseball, but would love to see them, you know, win a National League pennant, right? And then you take your chances in a 7-game series with there. But the Brewers know just how great Jackson Chourio is. He was signed to an 8-year, $82 million Major League contract with the Brewers in December. The Brewers did not have to do that. They bought him out of a significant number of years of arbitration, of years that Chourio potentially would have a greater earning potential. The Brewers bought him out now, hoping that they're going to pay him a premium for his first couple of years in the major leagues and hope to get a significant discount on the back end of his contract, which with some options at the end of them could be a deal up to $140 million over 10 years, which for someone who is getting comped to Mike Trout, he would be worth a lot more than 10 years, $140 million on the back end there with those options of being $25 million a piece. Baseball money is fake as heck. He is so exciting. I have gotten to see him in a couple of at-bats when I went for spring training last year in Arizona. I just missed him in the month that I spent in Nashville. Unfortunately, I think literally I left Nashville. I lived there for like a month last summer, and he came up to the Sounds. I think it was like 3 days after I ended up leaving Nashville. So a little bit of unfortunate timing on my part, but should be just an amazing talent to watch, to grow. And he might struggle in the beginning the way new major league players do. Maybe he'll get sent back down to Nashville at a certain point. You never know. But he's on a major league deal. They're going to try to keep him in the major leagues as much as possible. And you're going to see Jackson Chourio plastered all over marketing tools for the Milwaukee Brewers, because he is a player with the potential of changing the direction of this franchise, potentially all on his own. Can smack the heck out of the ball. He can play in the outfield very well. He should be a lot of fun to watch. The second thing, not on the offensive side, but the Brewers, can they cobble together a pitching staff? After Brandon Woodruff got injured last season, was unable to pitch, Milwaukee and him parted ways. He goes to free agency, ends up coming back late in the process to Milwaukee. But Brandon Woodruff isn't going to pitch this year. He has a lot of injury rehab to do, and he's a while away from actually pitching. His deal is structured so that he's going to get some money in year two to actually try to pitch then. So that's one of the big three starting pitchers down. Also, of course, the Milwaukee Brewers traded Corbin Burns. He goes off to the Baltimore Orioles. That trade happening not too long ago. Corbin Burns was the opening day starter for Baltimore. Okay. That leaves you with Freddie Peralta. Freddie Peralta, Fastball Freddie, is your number one starter, your opening day starter for the Milwaukee Brewers. After that, starter tomorrow on Saturday is DL Hall, who the Brewers acquired in trade this winter. And then Cullen Ray, who has some major league starting pitcher experience, got slid into that role last year due to pitching staff injuries. It's not like he's the world beater. This pitching staff needs some work if and when the Brewers are ultimately going to contend. And I don't think that's this year. I think this is the first time in quite a while that, look, I don't think the NL Central is great. So maybe I eat my words and say that the Brewers ultimately end up in a race for the Central pennant. But I think this is one of the first years in a while that I'm not going into this campaign expecting the Brewers to walk out with a division title. Part of that is because of the pitching. And another one of those members of the pitching staff is Aaron Ashby. Aaron Ashby is starting in Nashville. He's not ready to go after some injury shenanigans that have hurt him. On the back end, in the closing role, Devin Williams, he's struggling with a back injury. He was just put on the 15-day IL this morning, and it's been expected for a while that he isn't going to be able to pitch until late April, maybe longer. That's rough that you do not have a starting pitcher situation set up or a closing pitcher situation set up. And I think the Brewers are going to go one of three ways at the closer spot. It's going to be Trevor McGill, it's going to be Abner Uribe, or it's going to be Yoel Piamps. And if it's Uribe, some Brewers fans might have a sour taste in their mouth given the last time they saw Abner Uribe pitch with him blowing up against the Arizona Diamondbacks in the wild card round to close out last season. So that might not be very fun for fans. Otherwise, you have Yoel Piamps, who I think is actually going to get the nod in the closer role while Devin Williams is injured. Because if you think back to how Devin Williams ended up in the closer role, it was following the trade of Josh Hader. Before that, Devin Williams was the setup man for Hader. Over last season, Yoel Piamps kind of found his way into that setup man role. I would imagine that some of the continuities of leadership between Craig Counsell and now to Pat Murphy are going to build on those same organizational tendencies and lead to Milwaukee doing some of these same things, pushing some of these same buttons, where ultimately Yoel Piamps gets that role moving from setup man to closer, just like Devin Williams himself did. We have one more big storyline that I want to get to. But before we do that, I do want to tell you about some of our great friends over at TickPick, because there is no better time to take advantage of ticket deals than baseball season. Because look, I love living in Milwaukee because there is such a great baseball scene here. I could go and drive down to any of the suburbs, go down and see the Kenosha Kingfish, go see the Lake Country Dockhounds. I could drive over and see the Milwaukee Brewers, catch a bus on Brady Street to go see the Milwaukee Brewers basically whenever I want. And when I do that, when I go see the Milwaukee Brewers, and I go and see the Brewers quite a lot, right? Sometimes just need to get out of the house, break up the routine, grab the laptop, get some work done at the ballpark. And I do that, you know, on a Wednesday from time to time. And when I do, I buy my tickets on TickPick, because TickPick is the only place to get no fee tickets. You're never going to pay a single dollar in fees, no service fees, no delivery fees when you buy your tickets on TickPick. Plus, I'm going to save you 10 bucks on your first order. How about that? Save you 10 bucks on tickets to the Milwaukee Brewers home opener, which you can get into on TickPick starting at just 14 bucks. You can get into Milwaukee's Friday night game against the Mariners for just $9. How about that? And I'll save you 10 bucks more on your first order if you want to get some nicer tickets down there. It's also one of the best ways that you can help the show is by using my link. It's on the screen now, the link that's in the podcast description. Head over to TickPick. Hey, no fees on tickets for concerts, sporting events, comedy shows ever again. And save 10 bucks on your first order by using my link in the podcast description. The last big story for the Milwaukee Brewers heading into opening day is, will a freshman take a step? Here's all this whole big series last year put out by the Brewers digital media team about the freshman, Garrett Mitchell, Sal Frelick, Bryce Turang, Joey Weimer. How are all these young guns going to shape up for the Brewers? And just like at the top of the show, we talked about maybe Jackson Chourio struggles. The freshman last year did struggle a little bit, so much so that Joey Weimer is starting the season back at AAA. Garrett Mitchell is injured and isn't playing here. And he, you know, was playing pretty well last year before he suffered an injury and never quite got back where he needed to be. Bryce Turang, Sal Frelick are on the opening day roster, but they're not in the starting lineup. There are significant questions here about what happens for Milwaukee if these players that the front office has put, I think, a lot of responsibility for shouldering the team into its next window for contention. What happens if these players do not live up to expectations? That's going to put the organization in a really difficult spot, because everything has kind of been building up to this crew of young, talented prospects to take over this team as some of the other Brewers age out of where they need to be, of a situation where maybe Willy Adames doesn't get signed back, and you get Bryce Turang sliding over to that shortstop role. What about if you end up deciding to take a big lump on the contract and you cut ways with Christian Yelich? All right, well, then you have a lot of outfielders there with Sal Frelick, Jackson Chourio, Garrett Mitchell, Joey Weimer to do a lot with. What if none of this works? What if some of it doesn't work? If there is anything bigger to watch this season, I'm unsure what it is. Because if Milwaukee is going to compete for the division this year, in a way that would surprise me, it's going to be because the freshmen take a big sophomore step. That would be huge for this team to know that you have put together a core that is going to give you another opportunity to compete for a team that not too long ago, 6 years ago, was a game away from the World Series. If, on the other hand, you have all these position players flame out, or most of them flame out, you're now left with a pitching staff that has gone from aging to decimated. Something that you think you're going to be able to work on with your prospect pool, with your organizational resources. But then on top of that, also having to build back up the positional talent. Doing both of those things at the same time is difficult. There's only so many resources to go around between, you know, draft stock and players already in your prospect pool and your top-end major league talent to trade, shuffle around, and make moves with for the long term. Having to do both of those things at the same time, having to build the roster back up from nothing, would be very hard. The Brewers have put themselves in a position, you know, absent some injury difficulties here with the pitching situation. And I think there is also some serious concern about the organization not having starting pitching talent in the way that they would hope to do. There's some great talent in the back end, like Ethan Small, who I think is going to be awesome and will pitch at the major league level in some capacity. But I'm not sure that's a starting role. There is concern about starting pitching talent in the pipeline. If you have to combine that, and that's one of the hardest things to create. Like, so just about any Major League Baseball fan could say their team is struggling with starting pitching. But if you have to combine that with the idea that the plan that you made for the position talent does not live up to what it needed to be, this team could be in for a rough few years. So this is a really big picture question, but is probably the biggest question that will need an answer by the end of this Milwaukee Brewers season. And I can't wait to see it. I can't wait to find out what it is. I got to go because I got to go catch a flight to New York. Go hang out at Citi Field this weekend. Go catch the Milwaukee Brewers on opening weekend. We'll be back. We'll be here still. We'll be talking, you know, transfer portal news if it pops up. Big storylines. You know, we got you here on the Scotty Six Pack Podcast. Thank you. Thank you for listening to the only podcast talking all things Wisconsin sports with you 6 days a week. I've been your host, Kendrick Stumbris. You can find me on the website, formerly known as Twitter. While you are here, leave a nice review. 5 stars, kind comments. It really, really helps the show. Like I said, we have had our two biggest shows ever on back-to-back days the last two episodes. It has been awesome. I'm loving all the support. I really, really appreciate it. Kind words. You all are, you know, do this for y'all. Really appreciate it. Subscribe on YouTube, youtube.com/@ScottySixPack, where you can watch the show as well. Hit that like button over there. Really helps the show. The algorithm rules us all. Rules us all. Until we talk to you again very soon. Let's go, crew.